I think you played a game that you mentioned earlier in what you achieved this week. You want to talk to us a little bit about Shadows of Mordor?
That's true. I started playing, like Bobby just said, Shadows of Mordor, and it's so good that the first day I spent playing it, I sent Bobby a message and said, "Hey, I need to be on Boss Battle because I need to tell everyone how amazing this game is." The last time I was as kind of enamored with a game as I am with this was Assassin's Creed 4, and it's when I say enamored, I mean like I wake up early and think about playing it before I go to work. You know what I mean? Like I'm excited to come home and play this game.
Oh, when Call of Duty first came out, when we first started playing it, I had dreams that like Predator drones were striking me, and I would hear them in my sleep and be like, ah! I'd wake up. It was like almost like, well, no, not really.
Yeah. It's amazing, this game. So the point of the game is you're a ranger who is possessed by the spirit of an elf or something along those lines. It's not really that important. The point is, it's kind of like an open world game, and you run around killing orcs, right? And the elf spirit gives you magic powers. But the catch is the orcs. There's a hierarchy to the orcs. There's captains, and then there's bodyguards, and then there's war chiefs, and that power balance is always shifting. Like if an orc kills you, they get a promotion. If a random grunt orc that doesn't have any rank kills you, they get promoted to captain,
Oh,
and
wow.
their boss gets promoted, and on down the line. It's really, that's what makes the game really, really interesting. As far as the actual gameplay, it's the combat is kind of Batman, the Arkham Asylum and Arkham City games. And all the way down to like the counter button that pops up above the enemy's heads. And as far as exploring the world, it's kind of like Assassin's Creed. But it's so addicting and really hard, and you die a lot, which means your orc enemies get stronger and stronger, and they taunt you. Like, say you have a fight with a captain and you're losing and you run away. The next time you see him, he'll make fun of you for running away the last time you saw
Nice.
him. The other nice thing is, so there's this one orc that killed me, some random grunt, and he got promoted to captain. Next time I saw him, I killed him. I killed him from a distance, shot him in the eye with an arrow, and he fell into a fire. He survived that, came back with a big metal plate over the side of his head,
Awesome.
and said, "You can't kill me the same way twice." And he was invulnerable to ranged attacks, and I had to go in and fight him like one on one.
Oh, wow.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah,
That's some like high tech stuff right there.
it is a lot of fun. It is crazy. And these orcs, they taunt you constantly, and they get under your skin. And I was playing when we were watching Raw last night. I was playing the game, and
Yeah, I was gonna mention that.
this you will curse a lot when you play this game, because they're not just random enemies. They have personalities, and they make you hate them. So I absolutely recommend going and picking up. I'm playing it on PC. I think it's out for PS4 and Xbox One, and then there's a
Yeah.
PS3 and 360 launch, I think, later this month or next month.
I wonder if the Xbox 360 one's going to be in PS3 are going to be as in depth.
I think so.
Oh, really? Oh,
Yeah,
wow.
I think. I mean, it's like the same game. It's just like textures and graphics and
Yeah.
everything like that. Because that is the hook of the game, is the hierarchy and the way that orcs come back and everything like that.
Awesome. Let's check that out.
It's a lot of fun. I'm probably going to start playing it when we wrap on the show.
Okay.